Are you wondering why you have been feeling so alone lately? It seems that these days you feel better in solitude and can't cope with the energy of the people around you. We all love socializing and spending time with friends and family, so isolation doesn't seem like a desirable state. But what if loneliness is part of God's plan for you? Even if it seems difficult, there might be a beautiful reason behind it. Imagine if God wants to isolate you for a special purpose. This solitude can help you grow and change in ways you never imagined. In this video, we will learn why God has cut you off from your surroundings. So, watch until the end to get the full picture and subscribe for more inspiring content that can change your life. In normal human consciousness, if someone likes to stay alone, it might mean they are depressed. However, in the spiritual realm, God's isolation of you does not harm your mental health, but rather contributes to your growth. When God leads you to a place of quiet, He assures you of His presence all the time. Sometimes isolation happens due to your misdeeds, but God can use even negative experiences for your benefit. Isolation can also be a result of the overwhelming noise of life. When you realize the need for silence to hear God's voice in your Christian journey, isolation becomes inevitable. If you resist God's call to solitude, eventually it will force you to it. Therefore, it is wise to immediately heed God's call to isolation, as it is necessary for spiritual growth. Have you heard about the nocturnal leopard? This charming creature is known for its elusive behavior. These majestic cats are most active at night. Their senses and spotted fur allow them to chase prey and set up ambushes during the day. They hide to avoid larger predators like lions and hyenas, which are more active in daylight. An amazing feature is their ability to conserve energy during the day, making them more vigilant and agile at night. Have you ever wondered why you've been feeling entirely alone lately? It seems like these days you feel best in solitude and can't tolerate the energy of people around you. We all seek social interaction and value the time spent with friends and family, so isolation hardly seems appealing. But what if loneliness is part of God's plan for you? Even though it may seem difficult, there could be something beautiful hidden behind it. Imagine if God isolated you for a special purpose. This solitude could contribute to your growth and changes that you never anticipated. In this video, we'll discuss why God has separated you from your surroundings. So watch until the end to get the full understanding and subscribe for more inspiring content that can transform your life. In everyday life, if someone prefers solitude, it might indicate depression. However, in spiritual life, God's isolation doesn't harm your mental health. Instead, it promotes growth. When God leads you to a place of quiet, He promises His presence throughout your journey. Sometimes isolation is caused by your mistakes, but God can even use negative experiences to your advantage. Isolation might also be a response to the excessive noise of life. When you realize the need for silence to hear God's voice, solitude becomes inevitable. If you resist God's call to solitude, eventually it will lead you to it. Therefore, it's wise to heed this call immediately, as it is essential for your spiritual growth. Have you ever heard about the nocturnal leopard? This mysterious creature is known for its hidden lifestyle. These majestic cats are most active at night. Their instincts and spotted fur allow them to hunt and ambush. During the day, they hide to avoid encounters with larger predators like lions and hyenas. They also conserve energy during the day to be more alert at night. The nocturnal behavior of the leopard helps it survive in its natural habitat. What if its story is similar to the life of a Christian? Sometimes, there's a need to hide or stay in the shadows, like the leopard, for various reasons. To protect oneself from harm or to conserve energy for more important moments. If you are a Christian and rarely spend time alone, it's time to learn to occasionally isolate yourself and embrace solitude as something necessary for your well-being. Time spent in solitude can be a period for reflection, preparation, and rejuvenation. Not doing this regularly can cause more harm than good. However, what if God initiated this isolation? That makes it even more significant. Let's consider why God separates you from others. This knowledge will help you embrace this process, not reject it. Firstly, isolation provides the opportunity to be alone with God amidst a hectic life. Various activities can consume you so much that you lose connection with God's presence and voice. It's like trying to listen to someone in a noisy place where distractions drown out the message. Similarly, the busyness of your life can drown out God's voice. Living a life that doesn't hear God's word is very dangerous. Dangers include making mistakes that could cost your life or something significant. Additionally, it could lead to a life that deviates from God's plan and purpose, causing you to miss out on the abundant life He offers. Therefore, it's important to always stay connected to God's voice. Often you might pray and feel like God isn't speaking to you, but perhaps it's because you aren't truly listening. In His mercy, God sometimes leads you into isolation away from noise and distractions, so you can hear His voice. Have you ever felt lost at a crossroads, not knowing which path to choose? If so, you know the anxious feeling that comes with uncertainty. Nobody likes this feeling, but it's common in your life journey. However, when God isolates you, it could be His way of bringing clarity to your situation. Whether it concerns your overall life or specific aspects that seem misplaced, clearly, in these moments, God offers a clear blueprint, a divine plan for managing your life. Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3 echoes a promise, "Call to me, and I will answer you, and tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know." This verse assures you that God wants to reveal His plans and purposes to you. He doesn't want you to remain confused. So instead of allowing the feeling of isolation to discourage you, see it as an opportunity to cry out to God for clarity. He promises to respond and show you great and unsearchable things you have yet to know. So what are you waiting for? Call out to Him, seek His face, and watch as He opens your eyes to His direction and the purpose of your life. In the story of the nocturnal leopard, you see an important lesson. Sometimes, before taking action, it's necessary to remain hidden, to prepare for what lies ahead and to conserve energy when it's truly needed. Similarly, God has a task for everyone, including you. However, not everyone is ready to immediately start their task due to various reasons, such as a lack of knowledge, preparation, or spiritual maturity. But you should know that for every task God has prepared for you, there is a corresponding period of preparation. This is a time of isolation, during which God leads you through the necessary training and growth to become who He has called you to be. Just as a loving parent wouldn't entrust a delicate task to a small child, God gives tasks only to those who are mature enough to complete them. This maturity is based not on age, but on spiritual growth. If God calls you to a quiet place, it is very important to respond and follow all His instructions. He may give you specific instructions and require a period of dedication necessary for your service. For example, John the Baptist lived in the wilderness and had a unique diet of honey and wild locusts. Your preparation might look different, as might your mentors, but rest assured that God knows what specific training you need, and He will lead you accordingly during this preparation period. It's important not to compare yourself with others around you. Plan your life knowing that God is preparing you for a purpose greater than you can imagine. Pay close attention to the training you receive, as it plays an important role in what awaits you ahead. The life of Jesus explains this best. When He was 12 years old during the Feast of Passover, Jesus stayed in Jerusalem without informing His parents. After 3 days of searching, they found Him in the temple courtyard, sitting among the teachers, listening attentively, and asking them questions. His understanding and answers amazed people at such a young age. Jesus had already joined the purpose for which God had called Him, but all this was part of His training, and the time had not yet come to start His public ministry. Sometimes you might find yourself in a similar situation where you are not yet on big platforms, but you are only given smaller opportunities. It's important not to rush ahead of God and not to get discouraged, but to remain faithful to the small things. In this context, isolation might mean that despite your gifts and talents, you have not yet received wide recognition, and your deeds may seem hidden. Don't think that God has forgotten you or that you are doing too little. It's simply because God is isolating you for some time. Be assured that when the time comes to showcase your gifts, nothing will be able to stop it from happening. So be patient with God. Let Him prepare you and lead you to your glorious destiny at the right time. Proverbs chapter 16 verse 9 says, "In their hearts humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps." This verse emphasizes that although you may make plans, God directs your paths and prepares you for your tasks. God's isolation can also be a protective measure, shielding you from harm and negative influences. Psalm chapter 91 beautifully describes the safety found in God's presence. In verses 1 and 14, the psalmist states that everyone who dwells under the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. "I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart." As you go further in the scriptures, the author speaks of various harms that occur both day and night. This shows that the world you live in is not entirely safe, but only by trusting in God and living in His presence can you find safety. When God calls you to Himself, it can be a sign that He wants to protect you from harm that you may not even foresee. There are numerous testimonies of how God reveals the enemy's plans so His people can avoid them. For instance, the story of Apostle Paul, who was imprisoned in Rome and on board a ship, felt impending danger. He warned the crew and the centurion that continuing the journey would lead to disaster. However, they decided to sail on, ignoring Paul's advice, leading to a severe storm and shipwreck on the island of Malta. Paul's warning demonstrates his sensitivity to the guidance of the Holy Spirit. God's isolation often leads you to a state where you are more tuned and sensitive to His guidance. It's a time to deepen your trust in Him and learn to discern His voice amid the world's noise. God's isolation is not a punishment, but a protection. It's His way of shielding us from harm and guiding us towards His perfect will during times of isolation. God may be protecting you from bad company. You might notice that some friends no longer check on you or can't reach you anymore. This could be because God has cut you off from their negative influence. This principle applies to friendships or relationships that do not have a positive impact on you. The Bible warns about the influence of bad company on your character. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 33 says, "Do not be misled. Bad company corrupts good character." If you aim to reach the top and fulfill the purpose God has prepared for you, be mindful of the people you associate with on your faith journey. There are certain people you need to let go of, and certain people you need to embrace. Embracing God's isolation is a way to purify your circle of influence, ensuring those around you lift you up rather than pull you down. It's time to assess your relationships and let go of those who hinder your growth. While it might be hard to give up certain friendships, it's important to trust that God knows what's best for you. He sees the bigger picture and knows the plans He has for you. Embrace isolation as a time of cleansing and preparation, believing that God is leading you to a place of greater blessings and fulfillment. During isolation, God may show you character flaws that need attention. It's also necessary to examine your own heart and behavior. God's love for you is so great that He wants to remove any defects that hinder your breakthroughs. Isolation can become a time for self-examination and improvement, allowing God to shine light on areas of your character that need enhancement. This process can be difficult, as it requires humility and a willingness to change. The stories of Nebuchadnezzar, Moses, and Saul in the Bible show how important it is to have a character pleasing to God. Nebuchadnezzar was punished for his pride. Moses could not enter the promised land due to his anger, and Saul lost his kingdom due to impatience and disobedience. The Bible clearly states the kind of fruit you should bear in your life. Anything that does not match this fruit is not what God desires from you. In times of solitude, you can reflect on your life and see where you might be going wrong. God's purpose is not to condemn you, but to cleanse and shape you into the image of His Son, Jesus Christ. When you embrace the process of self-improvement during isolation, you can trust that He is working in you to bring about positive changes. God wants you to continually grow and improve, allowing His Spirit to work in you and bear fruits of righteousness. This is important for the growth of your character and maturity, so that you can experience the fullness of life He has planned for you. God may show you that you rely too much on others. Isolation teaches you to depend on God instead. When you are always around people, you may depend on them for everything. But when God isolates you, you realize that He is the one you should rely on. Being alone reminds you that He is your strength and protector. It's a chance to get closer to Him and learn to trust Him more than anyone else. Understanding this, you feel safer knowing that God is always with you. Sometimes your isolation is not for you, but for others. Apostle Paul, who wrote his letters in prison, including letters to the Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, and Philemon, is an example of this. These letters contain encouraging instructions and deep theological ideas that have helped shape Christian faith over the centuries. They provide guidance on how to live a Christian life, cope with difficulties in church life, and remain faithful in difficult circumstances. Had Paul not experienced this period of isolation, he might not have written these letters, which today inspire and guide many. His story shows that sometimes isolation can be a time of great productivity and creativity. I understand your fears and anxieties, but remember, the isolation you're experiencing is not just a test of your patience or faith, but rather God's way of preparing you for something greater. Because God loves you and cares for you, He uses these moments of separation to teach you to trust Him more and to find confidence in Him. During this period of isolation, God wants you to deepen your understanding of His ways and His plans for your life. It's a time to rethink your priorities and values, to discover new horizons and opportunities that you previously overlooked. This period of detachment will help you see that God is calling you to something bigger and more meaningful. Like Jonah, who found God at the hardest moment of his life, and Paul, who used his isolation to write letters that still inspire many, you too can use this period for spiritual growth and development. Instead of viewing it as lost time, see it as a time of preparation for what is to come. Remember that God knows your future and leads you on the path that will bring you the best. Your isolation is a temporary period that will lead you to an understanding of God's purpose for your life. Trust Him and open your heart to His guidance and blessings. You are not alone, and God is always by your side, guiding and supporting you every step of the way. So, dear Lord, in this hour of isolation, I turn to you with prayer and faith. You see how I languish in doubts and worries, feeling detached from the world, but deep down I understand this is your will, a path to self-improvement. I ask you, God, to grant me the wisdom and strength to understand and accept your plan. Help me find in solitude and silence not only peace but also a deep understanding of your word and will. Free me, Lord, from unnecessary distractions. Fill my heart with calmness and confidence that you are always with me. Let each moment of this isolation become a step towards you, allowing me to deepen my faith and spiritual perception. Teach me to be patient like Jesus, who in silence and solitude prepared for his ministry. Give me the wisdom to distinguish true friends from those who might harm my spiritual growth. Let your protection surround me, and your presence be a comfort and reminder that I am not alone on this journey. Teach me to see and appreciate the blessings you have prepared for me, and the lessons I have yet to learn. Lord, if isolation is a consequence of my disobedience or mistakes, I sincerely repent before you. Wash me with your forgiveness and renew my heart, so I can follow you with pure thoughts and unwavering faith. Let this isolation become a time of my spiritual renewal and transformation, a time when I find new strength and inspiration to serve you and those around me. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for your unchanging love and mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray and give thanks. Amen. Share this prayer with those dear to you, so together we can strengthen our faith and inspire each other on the path of true love and devotion to the Lord. Your comments and reflections will help us make our ministry even more meaningful and inspiring.